But it's good to know that everything stayed intact. I've still got my equipment, and you know what? I'll try to bend this back out, or I'll spend another 130 bucks because you know what? It was well worth it in the long run to save all of my equipment. What's up, guys? Today, we're gonna talk about deterring theft. Because if you're anything like me, there's one thing I hate, and that's a thief. So stay tuned, we're gonna go over this product. All right, guys, so today we're gonna talk a little bit about deterring theft and what I've been using. Now, I want to say right off the bat, thank you to Rackem for sending me these. I was looking at getting an enclosed trailer last year, guys, and I talked to so many people that talked me out of it. I ended up getting a actual open trailer, but Rackem did send me two of these for my trailer, and they have been put to very good use, and they've actually been put to more use than what they're actually meant for. And we'll go over a little bit about that and show you one here in a second. But one thing about these is, you know, I love testing and trying things out before I recommend products to y'all. And that's one reason why it took me so long to get this video out, was because I wanted to try it for myself. I wanted to put it through the ringer. I wanted to beat this thing with a hammer. I wanted to put it on a car and see how well it would actually hold up. Now, we have done all of the following, and we do not have video of the car, however, but it did work very well, and I will show you the one that we used because it's got mud and dirt all over it from beating the crap into the dirt and coming back up. But anyway, you can buy these. These are RA-25. If you want to buy one or more keyed alike, then it's called a RA-25K, and the K is for keyed alike. So I have two of these. Each come with a set of keys, so I actually have four keys that will work with both sets. Of course, I only need one of these, but it will open both of them. Now, as we take a closer look, we'll start with the outside here. These are very, very rubbery, shall I say. A hard, nice, soft rubber molding around here, and this is to keep your rims, things like that, from getting scratched up from these. Plus, on the inside, they also have the rubber molding. Both sides are like that. If you notice, one side is a little bit bigger. The reason for that is this smaller side does 12 inches up to 15 inch tires, and then this bigger side here does 15 all the way up to 20 inch tires. So we'll show you some footage here of this on my mower, show you some footage here of this on my trailer, show you some footage of this on my GMC Denali with 20 inch rims. Even show you some footage with it on my ATV. These are meant for anything and just about everything. So if you've got a 12 inch up to a 20 inch tire, then it's probably gonna work. Now, they do tell you on their website that these may not work with some low profile wheels. So make sure these may work before you buy them, because they're pretty expensive. But let me tell you something. I'd much rather spend the money on something like this to deter a thief than have a thief take $300 or $400 of my equipment, if not more. Thank you. So let's talk about price point on these. Price point on these, well, you're looking at $130 for just one of these. If you get a keyed alike, because you plan on buying two or more, then you're looking at $140 a piece. Yeah, so $130 for one. If you buy the keyed alike, two or more, then you know, of course, cost you a little more because the locks are built the same. They do take these, I call these Coke machine keys. They're round, very, very good when it comes to not being able to pick one of these locks and so forth. So we're gonna open this thing up here, so you can literally just put your key in there, open it up. Now, if you notice, my key will not come out. It won't come out, but once you unlock it, then it will come out. But of course, you know, it stays in place. So on one side here, we actually have a latch, and this latch is what catches on the inside of this. So you just literally put it on your wheel. Once you stick it on your wheel, you don't even have to have the key in there. You can if you'd like to make it a little easier and then just pull the key out and re-push it together a little bit more if it does, but you do not have to have the key. As you hear, it clicks all the way together and then it's locked in place. So this has been a great thing. I'm very glad to have this product. This is definitely a product I would recommend to you. This is a product I would stand behind because I've put it through some crazy, crazy testing. So let's get into some of the testing we've done. I'll even do it in front of you just to show you how well these things are made and how well they hold up. And then we'll do our overview of these. So let's get going. All right, guys, so as you can tell, this one is completely filthy. It has been cleaned up some, of course, but what happened was I had a buddy that was getting rid of a Jeep, a vehicle, and it just, the motor had went out on it, so he constantly buys and gets rid of Jeeps. And I had one of these in the back of my truck, because whenever I get out of my truck, usually I lock my trailer up whenever I'm working during the summertime, winter, whatever. And so I had one of these in the back of my truck and I said, hey, I want to do a test if you're just going to jump this thing. And he said, all right. So we open it up, we put it on there, and as you can tell, it's completely filthy. It looks like these are bent a little bit inward, more than they should be, but that's because it's been through the ringer. Anyway, long story short, we throw this on there and we start going backwards and forwards. And what happens, guys, is your wheel is stuck inside this one side here. And once you start going forward, it catches and your wheel goes up against this. And it has nowhere to go. Your rim is on one side, your tire's right here. It's all it wants to do is push up and try to go up into the ground. Or if you're backing up, and once it catches, then guess what? It catches on your front top of your bumper there. And I mean, as you can tell, this thing is, it did get a little bit of it, but it pulls up on your bumper, and it will actually, if it's a rubber bumper like his was, it will break that bumper. These have held up amazingly. Did they bend a little? Yes, but you know what? They may have bent a little, but to this day, they still work just as good as the day Rackham sent them to me. We're gonna get a hammer, throw it on the floor, and we're going to beat the crap out of this thing and show you, you know, what's gonna happen. This is just a 4-pound sledgehammer. I can show you here, 4 pounds. Not sure if you can read that or not, but 4-pound sledgehammer, and I'm just gonna beat the living crap out of this thing. All right, guys, here we go. Start right here. So as you can tell, it bent a little bit. Here it bent, but the rivets did not come apart. and I was hitting on the edge to try to break the rivets apart. Go to this side over here, pretty much the same thing. We kind of hit here more than here, but still no rivets broke apart. We beat the crap out of this thing. Let's put a key in it, see what happens. All right, guys, so as you've seen, we beat the living fire out of this thing, and it held up, and that's what it's meant to do, is hold up. But the question of the day is, and we're gonna find out together, with all this being bent in as much as it is, what's gonna happen when we try to open it? So let's throw the key in here and see what happens. So, are you gonna be able to get it off? Well, if it's against the wheel, let's see if we can pull it apart like this. So if this was against the wheel on one side and I put a foot or something here, I would be able to grab this and pull this apart, even though they are bent to crap them back. So, you know, you just lost $130, but you saved your trailer. Is that worth it to you? You saved your truck, you saved your lawnmower, you saved your ATV, saved your UTV. $140, $130, very well money spent in my own defense. So I would have to say yes, definitely this is something I would recommend. So anyways, guys, definitely worth the price, especially to save a lot of money from somebody stealing something you paid a high price for. So there is a link down below in the description. We found out together the hammer beating thing of how that was gonna go. And of course, if somebody's trying to get it off with a sledgehammer, they're not gonna be able to get to this part because it's gonna be under the bumper or under the fender of your trailer, something like that. But they'll be beating on this part more than they'll be hitting this. So this was just to see what was gonna happen, but it's good to know that everything stayed intact. I've still got my equipment, and you know what? I'll try to bend this back out, or I'll spend another $130 because you know what? It was well worth it in the long run to save all of my equipment or to save my trailer, whatever it may be. So that's gonna do it for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks, Rackem, for sending me this out. And hope y'all enjoyed this review. See you soon.